Imelda Mendoza Agot owns a small eatery. Her television is always turned on even while she's working. She says she regularly watches news programs and teleseries.
Habang nagtitinda kami dito, nanonood kami ng TV, tingin sa TV. Bihira ko nga lang hawakan yung cellphone ko eh.
Her viewing habit is shared by millions of Filipinos whose main appliance at home is the television. And despite the rise of the internet and social media, Kantar Media says television is still king. In a survey with 10,000 respondents, TV viewership remains very high at 96% of the population, while almost 50% has access to the internet. Jay Bautista of Kantar Media says one factor in TV's dominance is that it remains a free service compared to a mobile phone.
Mabigat pa rin sa bulsa yung everyday kung babayad ka ng data cost.
Bautista adds the emergence of digital TV as well as satellite and cable TV have also helped raise TV viewership with the addition of new and clearer channels. But he admits the continued rise of the internet can be a threat to traditional media. The top reasons Filipino consumers use the internet are social media, video streaming, downloading pictures, and chatting. This is also a reason many videos go viral, including commercials, which normally air on TV.
Filipinos' penchant for watching videos online is actually a major trigger, particularly with the recent viral execution of one of the fast food companies.
Many advertisers are now looking online. 15 to 25% of the marketing budget of some companies are devoted to the digital space. But Bautista says TV will remain a major advertising platform. He says based on published rate cards, TV got the lion's share of advertisements at 466 billion pesos in 2016 compared to radio and print. Traditional media has been expanding to the digital space, creating websites, apps, and streaming services online, a trend which is expected to continue for years to come. Jackie Pascual, ABS-CBN News.